There once was a ship that put to sea. The name of the ship was a Bully of Tea. The winds blew up her bow, up down, oh, below my bully boys blow. Soon may the willow man come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tonguing is done, we'll take our leave and go. She'd not been 2 weeks from shore when down on her a right whale bore. The captain called all hands.
Hi guys, so good evening and welcome to my magical world. If you are new here, I usually read here and discuss things with you depending on my mood. Okay, and sometimes I also put my whatever is happening around me or in my life, if there is anything. So yeah, I'm feeling a bit better, but I still have cold. And that, yeah guys, so it's 10:52 in the evening currently. Okay, so let's start. How are you guys? Well, it's January na. It's January 2022 and I hope you guys are, you know, trying to get back to shape. You know, after all the holiday add-ons on our body. So, tonight we'll be discussing 5 positive ways you need to be humble for more happiness. So, yep. Let's read something like this. This is something that could help you out, guys. So we must not be wise and prudent according to the flesh. Rather, we must simply be humble and pure. This is actually really hard to do. Excuse me. It sounds like really simple, but you know, nowadays, people love to brag about a lot of things, right? So, only a few people can actually embody this. Pureness and humbleness. So, in our modern society, full of corporate power and stardom, being humble, being modest, is often viewed as a weakness. And the funny part is, we celebrate entitlement and elitist behavior in the name of social norm. So, what hope do we expect as a society if we celebrate overconfidence and elitist attitude? We're in the spiritual growth in that, aren't we all getting rather materialistic? So those were the questions you need to ask yourself, guys, if you wanted to just check on if you are being too much of something. Okay, so this is the reason being humble is such a deep necessity for our society at large. So, you know, this is also somewhat good for the people who wants to live a life. You know, a life, a low-key life, but a happy life. Yeah, something like that. So, let's read about the benefits of being humble. So, there are numerous benefits to being a humble person. First is more understanding. A humble person understands his or her limits and knows when to draw a line where it's needed. He or she has deeper understanding on the truths of life, and their perspectives are based on reality rather than ego. So, I know a lot of people have this egoistic based perception on things. So, it's important to, you know, be more understanding, guys, right? So don't judge right after, you know, if you saw that that person's life for just a few years, that's not her. It's just a few years of his or her life. It's not her entire life. So we cannot actually judge like anyone. Got it? Next is more generous. A humble person is always more generous than his ego. Driven or self-absorbed counterparts because he is able to place himself in the shoes of less fortunate and feel their pain. The ego-driven person lives in a bubble where another's pain cannot touch him. So, if you are like egoistic, of course, you no longer care of the other person or the other individual. So, you just always, you know, think about yourself, just your ego, how the world perceive you, right? So, it's important to be, you know, sometimes, be more generous, right? Next is more helpful. A humble person, on average, is more helpful than others. So, people who are more humble were more likely to offer help and offered more of their time to those in need. This is because they are more heart-centered and come from a space of love. So, as you can see, humble people have this kind of like really soft heart. So, it's good, but I hope you guys know how to use that humbleness of yours, okay? So, make sure that you will not be abused in any ways, in any form, okay? So, yeah. It's actually like a bit of a two topic, but somewhat related, so I'll just read this. So, this is actually the main topic that we are talking about. The five positive ways you need to be humble for more happiness. Stop feeding the ego. Don't feed your ego by surrounding yourself with people who always agree to whatever you say and hence massage your ego. A few people who bring you back to reality and say it like it is are essential to your growth and staying humble. Next is, start getting off your high shoe. High horse, sorry. Sorry, guys. So, always treat people with respect and dignity. Just because you are successful, that doesn't make you better than... Let's continue. Where am I? Wait. Wait lang guys. Wait a second. Okay. So, I'm gonna repeat, okay? Just because you are successful, that doesn't make you better than them or give them the permission to put others down. Staying grounded with your feet firmly on the ground is required for staying humble. So, do not be boastful, guys. Make sure that you are, you know, on that ground. Make sure to be grounded. You know what I mean, right? So, you know, remember that life is all about cycle. And at some point in our life, we will be in a point where we are down. So, always make sure to always be humble, okay? You don't know what anyone is undergoing through kindergarten or anything like that, guys. Make sure to think before you speak. Okay? Next is stop talking. Start listening. When you can stop talking incessantly about how great you are, you can actually start listening. And when you listen, you discover what others have to offer and give importance to their opinions before forcing yours down. Listening shows that you value others' opinions and insights. So, I know a lot of people wanted to like to talk and talk and talk. But people like me love to listen. So, I told you guys that I am before, like, I really look like a human diary. So, just saying. Next is, learn to apologize for mistakes. No one ever learned anything or impressed anyone by shifting the blame and making excuses for their actions. Apologizing and owning to your mistakes brings you back to your soul center of truth and purity. So, you make mistake, you admit it, and you then apologize, okay? And make sure at the end you tell that person that you're not going to do it again. Otherwise, it's your job to figure things out with your life, okay? Next is keep striving for excellence. If you are already successful, don't become complacent. Complacency is a fruit of ego, not humility. Keep pushing yourself further and keep growing. Excellence is a journey and not a destination. When you keep pushing yourself to higher levels of excellence, you keep understanding and working on your own limitations, which keeps you grounded. It's all part of self-mastery. So remember, guys, to always strive to be more and more humble with every passing day. So there's this quote from John Wooden that says, "Talent is God given. Be humble. Fame is man given. Be grateful. Conceit is self given. So be careful." So that was the entire article, guys. So I hope you learned something from this. It's not like deep, it's easy. It's just all about humbleness. And I know these things they don't talk about anymore, these things on school, because people always think that you guys already know this because you guys are smart, right? So I'm just here to reiterate it for you. And also, if you are a lazy reader, that's why I'm here also, guys. I'm also lazy, but I'm trying every day, okay? So I'm gonna update you with my life. Not yet, maybe later or tomorrow. So thank you guys for watching. Thank you for... Yeah, guys, so my battery got drained. Thank you guys for watching. Thank you for helping me make this world a better place for all of us and for the future generation. See you again later.
Swore he'd take the wheel in tow. Soon may the wellerman come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tonguing is done, we'll take our leave and go. Da 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 da.